You get stuck with a bad car deal? Here's some amazing news. It doesn't matter how recently or how long ago you signed the deal, if you're still making car payments, this video is for you. Hi, I'm Kevin Hunter, also known as the Homer Guy, and author of Is That the Best You Can Do? Welcome to the Homer Guy channel, home of YouTube's best information on buying and selling new or used cars, courtesy of the Homer Guy team. If you signed a bad car deal, even if it was 2, 3, or even 4 years ago, you can still do something to make it a heck of a lot better than it is right now. Your bad car deal can be fixed. For those of you stuck in a bad car deal, it's probably the result of somebody lying to you about a number of factors, including loan terms, interest rates, dealer products, and insurance plans they said you needed on your vehicle. A finance officer likely went even so far as to say your interest rate or your bank approval was based on you buying his products. Has this ever happened to you? It's a bold-faced lie. Have you ever wondered why it's so impossible to buy a car at a dealership without being lied to these days? It's really simple, captured in just one statement, and here it is. As long as your income is tied to telling a lie, the truth will never be known. All right, today we're going to talk about how you can fix your bad car deal, cancel a bunch of junk, lower your loan balance, and lower your car payments. This is great news, isn't it? At the end, you'll find great charts for maintenance costs and an entire list of stuff you can cancel well after the fact and get the stuff off your car contract. That and more coming up right after this short message from the Homework Guy team.
If you're a first timer on the Homework Guy channel, consider subscribing and leaving us a comment below. Add hashtag the Homework Guy if you'd like a response directly from Kevin or one of the Homework Guy staff members. We're always glad to help our loyal followers, and the best part is there's no charge. You can also email the team at info@thehomeworkguy.com with a specific question, or if you'd like a free contract review, just black out your personal information and send it to us. We'd love to hear from you. Just be aware that we do get a lot of requests, so just be patient while you wait for a response. Back to you, Kevin.
Let's get started fixing that bad car deal, shall we? Car dealers have long wanted buyers to believe that once you sign the contract, you're stuck. The truth is, you're stuck with some things, and others you're definitely not, because of the message you signed and drove away so it's yours that circulates out there. Car buyers rarely do anything about a messed up car deal. They just curse their luck until 3-4 years down the road when they try run the car dealer gauntlet again. There's no need to feel hopeless. The Homework Guy team has your back. Here we go. 3 major strategies to fixing a bad car deal. If you bought the vehicle within the last few days, it's possible you can return it. If you really don't like the car at all and you felt pressured into literally everything, you might actually be able to return the car. But this is an extremely time-sensitive issue. On your state websites, the car doesn't transfer from the dealer to the consumer immediately. Even if your state is blazing fast, the shortest time frame isn't likely to be anything less than 7 days. We're talking about the government here, after all, and for most states, it's a time frame of about 30 days. If you really don't like the car deal, you have to take action immediately after you left the dealership. Some dealers actually have a 3-day return policy, others allow as much as 7 days, like Carvana. That's the first thing to be aware of and a great thing to know going in. Does your dealer have a return policy? You have to be within the deadline, but this makes it very easy. For those of you who purchased a car at a dealer who didn't have a return policy, returning the car is still a possibility. Let's face it, some dealers are just plain jerks. You won't ever get a thug to help you, no matter how much you need it. And no matter how much they ripped you off. However, some dealers will recognize there's a problem and try to fix it, including taking the car back. I've seen it happen hundreds of times at dealers all around the country who never had a return policy at all. So always go ask. I have to emphasize that your chances of returning the car are largely dependent on whether the state transferred the title yet or not. If a title change happened, the only way that car is going back is on a trade-in. And you know you're going to lose thousands of dollars if you let that happen. You don't want that to be you. You can contact your state DMV with the VIN number of your vehicle, and they can tell you if the title has transferred. If that's not you who's on the title and it's still in the dealer's name, you have a chance. It's going to be an uphill battle, but you still have a chance. The rest of my strategies are for everyone else. You're well beyond a day or two. Maybe you signed your car deal a few weeks ago, months ago, or maybe 2, 3, 4, or more years ago, but you're still making car payments. That's all that matters. If you're still making car payments, that alone tells me that something can be done to clean up your bad car deal. Let's move on to number 2, chargebacks and product cancellations. We need to get rid of all those junk insurance policies you signed up for, and the good news is all of them can be canceled. Let's hit a few of the highlights of things that can go. Gap insurance. You can contact your dealer and cancel it immediately. This is a biggie and one that will get your car dealer squawking like a bunch of wounded ducks, but you can pull the plug on it. There's a couple of things I suggest you do if you do indeed need gap insurance, and I'll give you more details at the end. Extended warranties. If you haven't used the extended warranty you bought, you can end it right now. Again, contact your dealer immediately to cancel it. There are a couple of strategies I suggest for anyone considering repair costs for their vehicles, and I'll cover those again at the end. But extended warranties can all be canceled, and you'll get a prorated amount back or applied to the end of your loan if you financed. Service plans. Some people claim these are great, but remember that dealers use these to get you back in the building. The moment your cheeks hit their seats in the waiting area, expect to have interested sales staff come visit you about getting rid of your vehicle. You can cancel that service plan immediately. Wheel and tire protection, glass breakage protection, cancel it. You're not stuck with it. Make it disappear today by contacting your dealer. Life insurance, disability insurance, credit protection insurance. No, I'm not kidding. Get rid of all of it. Cancel it now. Key fob insurance might be the dumbest insurance package in the world. Cancel it. Save your money. Can you see your car payments shrinking already? Excess wear and tear protection. Are you driving your car through brush fires or something? No? Well, get this off your car loan right now. Canceled. Theft protection programs, especially window etching, VTR, or anything that involves numbers etched on your glass, cancel it now. It's just junk policy. Literally anything that sounds like protection and insurance of any kind can be canceled anytime you want, days, weeks, months, or even years later. They are called chargebacks or product cancellations, and you have the right to cancel them at any time. I'll pop a list of all of these products at the end. Everything I covered and more will be on the screen at the end of the video, and you can pause it and review your contract for any similar products. Number 3, refinance your car. You are not stuck with the car loan the dealer put you into, and the key thing to understand about a car loan is that it's very different from a home loan. Unlike a mortgage, there are no closing costs. If you want a different car loan, you can get one from anywhere you want, from any banker, and get a better rate. Get all your chargebacks and product cancellations done first, though, but then refinance the loan. Now, let's circle back to two things that we need to cover. My dealer followers are going to be up in arms about you canceling gap, and I have a video on this channel explaining exactly why you shouldn't have needed it in the first place. However, if you cancel your gap insurance policy and you think you needed gap, contact a third-party insurance provider and find a very inexpensive plan to take care of your needs. You certainly don't need that 1,000-pound hog policy the dealer sold you. Also, this is a great time for those of you who thought a zero-down cash deal made sense for you. Fix this mistake now. Send in a lump sum payment of any amount, preferably 20% of your loan balance, or start adding given dollars to your car loan every month to pay it down faster. I've already shown you how to save a significant amount of money on your car payments. Use the money you'll save from canceling products and refinancing your car loan and add that money back to your car loan each month. You'll be thanking me for years to come if you do this. This advice is pure gold, and you're never going to hear it from a dealership finance office. Last, I want to come back to the extended warranty and service plan crowd. I don't believe in these plans at all, and you might wonder how I do it. Perhaps you're one of those people who worries about your car blowing up, and you think you need a big fat extended warranty or service plan to bail you out. No, you don't. A lot of people are increasing their monthly payments anywhere from $45 to $100 a month by putting extended warranties on their loans, and that move likely forced you into a $1,000 gap policy too. So the monthly amount is more like $65 to $120 a month, all for a big what if? You didn't need what if insurance. You need a plan that works with your money in your pocket. Instead of giving money away to the dealership in terms of monthly payments, deposit the appropriate amount in a bank account each month that is separate from everything else you do. It's going to be your car maintenance and repair account. To help you know how much you should save each month to protect yourself, we've put together a simple chart with a number of makes and models with their 10-year track records for total repairs and maintenance and how much that comes out to on a monthly basis. You're welcome. Here we go. From highest to lowest, BMW 148, Mercedes 108, Cadillac 104, Volvo 104, Audi 103, Saturn 103, Mercury 100, Pontiac 98, Chrysler 88, Dodge 88, Acura 82, Infiniti 78, Ford 76, Kia 73, Land Rover 73, Chevy 73, Buick 72, Jeep 69, Subaru 68, Hyundai 68, GMC 65, Volkswagen 65, Nissan 63, Mazda 63, Mini 63, Mitsubishi 62, Honda 60, Lexus 58, Scion 53, Toyota 46, the low-cost winner. Did you notice how close these numbers are to the $65 to $120 a month you are blowing up on extended warranty plans and service plans and gap insurance? You've got your own insurance plan working with your own money, and you get to keep every single penny you end up not needing. Meanwhile, the dealer doesn't give you a cent back on anything you buy from them. Make sense? All right, if you appreciated learning how to fix a bad car loan today, consider giving us a thumbs up and leave a comment down below. Include hashtag the homework guy in your comments. Share the video on social media with family and friends and use the hashtag again. For those of you who like to say thanks for the tip, I'll leave the link for PayPal and Cash App that you see here. They'll be in the description box down below. I've helped millions of car buyers with videos, free car contract reviews, market updates, and much more, and will continue to give you this quality update. All of these videos you see here on the Homework Guy channel in the days ahead. To wrap up, we'll put the chart of products and insurance policies you can cancel in the end. Just pause the video and take a few notes. If you spot a product on your car contract that's different from something on the list, just know that dealers are very creative with insurance plans. You might have insured yourself against bad attitudes or bad breath. If it's not on the list, you can still cancel that kind of insurance too. Thanks for coming back and sharing our videos with everyone. It's much appreciated. You guys rock. I'm Kevin Hunter. Until next time, take care, everyone.